Hi friends, welcome to the channel Unshackling Sudoku and Puzzles. Ashish here, and today I'll be covering a puzzle genre called Akari puzzle or light bulbs puzzle. So this puzzle comes into the object puzzle, placement puzzle category, and today we'll be solving two puzzles of this genre. We have already covered this genre on our channel earlier, and I'll add the link in the description below for the previous video where we have covered some basic techniques on how to solve Akari puzzle. So today I'll be solving two puzzles, and both of these puzzles are constructed by William. So I really thank the author for such an excellent puzzles, because I have already solved these puzzles and I would say these are the excellent Akari puzzles constructed by William. So I really thank the author for giving us an opportunity to cover video on our channel, and both of these puzzles I just was leisurely solving, and I really enjoyed the way they have been constructed. The logic or the solve path that was executed in this puzzle is really excellent. So I was very much happy solving both of these puzzles by William, and I'll just race through the techniques that are involved in both of these puzzles, right? So before going to the puzzle, I would really suggest you to check out to the channel Unshackling Sudokus and Puzzles, the YouTube channel, if you haven't done so. Please subscribe to the channel. It will really motivate us to cover videos on daily basis. And if at all you have a request for any Sudoku variant or a puzzle genre, do let us know in the comment below and we'll surely make a video on it. And now coming on to this puzzle. So as name says, light bulbs, you have to place some light bulbs, or as you can see the cell here. So this is a bulb that I have placed here, and each bulb will light up all the white cells in the four orthogonal directions. So for example, if till the edge of the grid or towards till the black cell. So if I place a light bulb here, it will illuminate all the cells, possible cells the light bulb sees in all the four orthogonal directions, right? And in the grid, all the white cells. So all the white cells in the grid will have to be illuminated by the light bulb. And the numbers in the grid indicate the number of light bulbs that are placed in the orthogonal four directions or orthogonal four cells. So for if you have a 0 here, none of these 4 cells can have light bulbs. So if you have a 2 here, out of these 3 cells, 2 cells would have to have light bulbs. And if you have a 1 here, out of these 3 cells, you will have 1 cell as a light bulb. And one more important rule here is that light bulbs cannot see each other directly. So for example, if you have a light bulb here, this line or this vertical and horizontal column cannot have any other light bulb. So there cannot be 2 light bulbs that are seeing each other horizontally or vertically. So you can have a light bulb here because you have a black cell in between. So that is possible. But directly, 2 light bulbs cannot see each other. So I'll again brief you with the rules. So the object of this puzzle is to place light bulbs in some grid squares. Each light bulb illuminates every square in the grid in each of the 4 directions, right? And until it hits a black cell or a edge of the grid. Every grid square must be illuminated, and no 2 light bulbs may illuminate each other or can see each other. A black cell with the number indicates how many of the 4 surrounding cells may have the light bulb. So that is what the rules is, and with that we'll start solving this puzzle. So the basic things that I have covered in my earlier video are the diagonal logic, right? So if you have a 2 and you have only 3 cells for the 2 to be fulfilled, so the diagonal cells cannot have the light bulb. So if this is a light bulb, then both of these cells get eliminated and you have only 1 cell for the 2 to be fulfilled, which is not possible, right? So you always have these cells as not being part of the light bulb, right? And the next thing is that, so here at this point of time, you have that excellent logic that has been executed in this puzzle by William. So the logic here is that none of these cells, so this, there cannot be a light bulb here. So there are many ways to see this way, see this logic. And the first thing is that you have 3 ones here, right? You have 3 ones, and all of these 3 ones are not connected to each other by there is no possibility that one light bulb can fulfill both the ones, right? So that is not possible. For example, if you have a 1 here, then if you have a light bulb here, this one and this one simultaneously gets fulfilled. But for these 3 ones, there is no such possibility, right? So which means that you need 3 light bulbs to fulfill these 3 ones. One light bulb will have to be somewhere in these 3 cells. one light bulb will have to be somewhere in these three cells, one light bulb is possible here and one light bulb is possible here. So you have four areas where out of these four areas, three areas or three cells will surely have one light bulb, which means that this cell cannot have a light bulb. So the moment you have this cell as a light bulb, two areas are eliminated of having a light bulb for these three ones, and you have only two areas for the three ones to fulfill the light bulb. So for example, if you see here, both of these ones will have light bulb here. Easy way to see that. So if you have a light bulb here, both of these ones can be fulfilled by having light bulbs in these two cells, and they can see each other now, which is not possible. So which means that all of these cells will never have a light bulb. Easy way to see is this one only. If you have a light bulb here, both of these ones will have light bulb here. Not possible, right? So this was the easy way to see. Now if you see here, this one can have light bulb either here or here, and in both the case this will not be a light bulb. Same way this, same way this, and same way this. See the way the puzzle has been executed, right? The pattern of this puzzle is really excellent, and now with that we'll continue the puzzle. Now one more excellent thing here in this puzzle is that if you see these four ones, now all of these four ones are connected to each other. How? Let me say you, like, they are very far away, but still they are connected by one or the other way. So if you have a light bulb here, for this one you'll have a light bulb here, here, and here. So there are only two ways these four ones can be fulfilled, either by having a light bulb here in all these four cells, or by having a light bulb here in all of these four cells, right? See here. So this gives us one logic that one of these two cells will have a light bulb, one of these two cells will have a light bulb, one of these two cells will have a light bulb, and one of these two cells will have a light bulb, which means that all other cells in that row and column cannot have a light bulb. Excellent logic, right? That is excellent the way it has been executed. If you see here, you can directly eliminate so many cells here. So either this cell or this cell will have a light bulb, so all of these cells can be eliminated. Either this cell or this cell will have a light bulb, so all of these can be eliminated. So if you see here, too many eliminations, right? And with that, now the puzzle is solved actually. So if you see the way it has been constructed, you can directly solve the puzzle now. The moment I have a light bulb here for the one, this one will have a light bulb here, and this one now has two light bulbs instead of one, which means that this cell cannot be a light bulb, and now for this one, this would have to be a light bulb. For these two will have to be a light bulb. For this one, this would have to be a light bulb. For these two will have to be a light bulb. So as you can see here, the way it has been constructed, the moment you get one light bulb here, the whole puzzle is solved. Now if you see here, this one will have to have a light bulb here, this one will have to have a light bulb here, and there is only one. So as the logic proceeds, the rule of this puzzle is that every white cell has to be illuminated by a light bulb. So if at all you come across such squares or such cells that are not illuminated by any light bulb, and which means that still that square can be a light bulb. So this can be a light bulb. Now both of these cannot be the light bulbs. For this one, this would have to be the light. For this one, this would have to be the light. For this one, this would have to be the light. And for this one, this would have to be the light. And for this one, this. Right? So this is eliminated here. So as you can see here, I've solved most of the puzzle is solved. Now if you see here, this one will have a light bulb here, this one will have a light bulb here. Excellent, right? Now one of the excellent way to proceed this puzzle is that you have to look out for squares where only one cell can illuminate another cell. So if you have a white cell that is still isn't illuminated, and there is only one way to illuminate it, which means that if you see this square, there is only one way you can illuminate this square or this cell which is having a light bulb here. Excellent, right? Same way for this, you'll have to have a light bulb here. For this one, for this cell, it has to be the light bulb to illuminate it, and there is no other way any other light bulb can illuminate this cell, which means this cannot be a light bulb. Now if you see here, the puzzle gets completed here. The end part is really, really excellent. So if you see here, this cell can be illuminated by only one other cell, which is this cell, which gives one for this, which gives this, and this one has a light bulb here. which means this has to be illuminated by itself. This cell can be illuminated by this light bulb, this cell can be illuminated by this light, this cell, and you get the puzzle done. What an excellent Akari puzzle this was, guys. Excellent puzzle, right? And I am really excited to solve the next puzzle, which is much more complicated and excellent puzzle, I would say. Purely logical. So this is the second puzzle that I was talking about. Excuse me. I'll just reduce the grid size here. Okay. And if you see here now, this is a very good puzzle. I solved this puzzle and I was really happy able to look for the logic, and I was able to find the logic. So let us now solve this puzzle actually. So if you see here, this one will eliminate this cell, because if there is a light bulb here, both of these cells will never have a light bulb. Same way, now this one can eliminate this cell, this one will eliminate this cell, and this one will eliminate this cell. Same way, you have ones here as well, so you can do the same thing here. So as you can see here, there is kind of a symmetry type of givens placed here. The only the unsymmetrical clue is this black cell, which is not being seen here, right? And all other cells are symmetrically placed, all other clues are symmetrically placed, but the logic is totally different, I would say. One of the excellent logics that I have seen. And now if you see here, there was one of the logic that I saw was both of the upper part and the below part of ones are symmetrically placed, or in other words, they are identically placed, and which means that whatever you have a light bulb here, might be possible that you will have the same light bulb placed in the upper part of the region, if at all they are not connected to the middle part of the grid. Now if you see here, all of these four ones, 1, 2, 3, 4, has exactly two possibilities, right? Which means that all of these four ones together have only two possibilities for placing the light bulbs. So if you have a light bulb here, this one will have a here, this one will have here, and this one will have here. Excellent, right? So if you see here, one way of placing the four light bulbs are this way. And for example, if you have the light bulb here, for this one you'll have here, for this one you'll have here, and for this one you'll have here. So if you see, one of the excellent logic that I saw in this puzzle was, the first thing that I saw was, let us see that this one placing the four light bulbs in one manner or one way, you have only one light bulb remaining here. Let's see what happens the other way, right? So which means that in both the cases, if you see in both the cases, this row will have either light bulb here or here, right? As you can see here, this one or this one will have either light bulb here or here. So in this row, you'll have the light bulb either here or here. And if both the places you won't have the light bulb, you can see that this one or any of the other ones will get contradiction here. So in other words, I would say that this row will never have any more light bulbs in this in these of these cells, out of these two cells. Same way, it will have the same logic here in the upper part of the grid. In this upper part of the grid, you will have either light bulb here or here in this row, which means that all other cells cannot have the light bulbs. Now if you see here, another piece of logic is that if you see the the placement of twos now, if you have a light bulb here for this upper part, the lower part cannot have the same light bulb in the same place. I mean to say, if you have the light bulb for one here in the upper part, the same column cannot have the light bulb here in the next row, in the other row. Why? Because what happens here is that both of these two will get contradiction here. You won't be able to place exactly four light bulbs for these two twos in the three columns. So how I managed to see that? Let me explain you. There is a very excellent logic and very, very good logic. I would really love to explain you. If you see here, both of these twos can only be fulfilled by having four light bulbs, right? And one of the light bulbs can be in one of these two cells, right? In this column, you'll have one of the light bulbs. In one of the light bulbs can be in one of these two cells, and one of the light bulbs can be in one of these two cells. So the maximum number of light bulbs that you can place in these two twos can only be three, but you need 4 because this 2 will have 2 light bulbs and these 2 will have 2 light bulbs. So you need 4, which means that if you have a light bulb in the bottom area somewhere in this cell, then the upper part of the ones will have the light bulb in the opposite cell, symmetrical area. So one of the logic is fulfilled now. Now if you see all the 2s here, right, you need exactly, you will have exactly 5 light bulbs for these 2s in this 3 columns, I would say. So one of the light bulbs will be in one of these 2 cells, right? As we have already discussed, you will have one light bulb either here or here, and both the cells cannot have the light bulbs. So one of the light bulbs will be in somewhere in one of these 2 cells, and you need 4 more light bulbs for these 2s. So totally 5 light bulbs in these 3 columns, right? So this cell, this column, these 3 cells can have one light bulb. These 2 cells can have another light bulb, 2. These 2 cells can have another light bulb, 3. These 2 cells can have another light bulb, 4. And the 5th light bulb will have to be this. So you need to count the number of cells in that particular area and how many light bulbs it can have, right? So you can have maximum of 1 light bulb in these 3 cells, 2nd light bulb in these 2 cells, 3rd light bulb here, 4th light bulb in these 4 cells, 3 cells, and 5th light bulb will have to be this cell, which is near to the 2, right? So as we have already discussed, there has to be 5 light bulbs in this area. One will be somewhere in these 2 cells, 2nd and 3rd will be here, 4th and 5th will be here. Same way for this 2, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, right? Now this logic is extended, guys. Excellent logic, a very very excellent puzzle. Now if I extend this logic, we have already discussed that one of these 2 cells will have to be a light bulb, and for same placement in these 2 twos, one of these 2 cells will have to be a light bulb, which means that if you have a light bulb here, in these 2 cells you'll have a light bulb here. Same way if you have a light bulb here, you'll have a light bulb here. Excellent, right? And which means that now these 3 cells cannot be the light bulb, because you have a light bulb here or here and here or here, right? Which means that now if you see the 2s here, there is only one possible way you can fulfill the 2s. Having a light bulb here. If you don't have a light bulb here, for these 2 2s you'll have to fulfill this way. So you'll have a light bulb here, and for this 2, one light bulb will have to be here or here, and other will have to be here or here. Again, alternating either this way or this way. And in both the cases, now what happens here, if you see here, all of these cells are eliminated as part of not being the light bulbs. And now that completes this puzzle, guys. What an excellent puzzle this is. That really really completes this puzzle. So if you see here, this one has only one way to do, this one has one way to do. That directly completes this awesome puzzle. This and this. And which means that now you have only 2 cells left for the 2. You have 1 cell left for this 2. 1 cell left. Okay. I mistakenly have marked this as non-light bulb cell. So this will be a light bulb. This has to be a light bulb for the 2. And these 2 will have to be light bulb for this 2. Now these 2 will have to be light bulbs for this 2. And the remaining cells will have the light bulbs. What an excellent puzzle this was, guys. Really really mind-blowing puzzle. It was an excellent puzzle, and the way the logic proceeds in this puzzle is awesome. I really enjoyed solving both of these puzzles, and I really thank the author for such wonderful puzzles. So I hope you enjoyed the video. I will add the link in the description below if you want to try it yourself and see how the logic works. And I'll add the link in the description below for the earlier video as well. So I hope you enjoyed the video. Do like and comment if you want us to solve any other Sudoku variant or a puzzle genre. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Thank you.